A very good morning to the program coordinator and the conference chairman of 3rd KLIC 2021. I'm Dr. Pavani Jaya Subramaniam. Today I feel proud and thankful to the conference chairman and also the program coordinator to involve in this multidisciplinary research. Well, my warmest welcome and wishes to the other participants in this conference as well. As my part in this research conference, I would like to present about the effect of national culture dimensions on full-range leadership styles and organizational commitment. Without further ado, let's look at the leadership. What do you understand by leadership? If you ask me, people will always say that leadership means something that innate within us, and we see leaders are always born as leaders. But in my opinion, if you ask, a leadership is fully of intellect. And how do we use our intellect in a proper manner? That means we know how to arrange or organize our intellect. So when do we know this? We are a very good leader. And the leadership skills will automatically belong to us. Leader should be someone that are very high sensible person. And he could know to the sense of the insight, which means able to see something that other people doesn't see. And that makes you different between manager and leader. Well, at the same time, when I say about leadership styles or the way that how we manage something or we bring something or we lead our subordinates, it is all mingled with our culture and how we are brought up. If you ask me, in Malaysia, which is pluralistic society, we have our own norm, traditions and the way how we are brought up. For example, in a layman's situation, I can explain that when we are in childhood time or in a very young age, our parents do always say that if you see problems outside, you should not go and involve, or you should not even see or have a look at that. So this is showing that we have to confront all the problems or avoid the problems. So this is being our attitude all the while. So how do we really bring up a leadership skills within such kind of attitude? I'm not going to blame anyone on this, but this is our manner of bringing up a child in a proper attitude. But at the same time, the culture itself is being impacted to in a different way to absorb another skills, and that's what I want to mention. So that is why in this research I have bring up the national culture dimension as a moderator to see the relationship between leadership styles and also organizational commitment. Well, for me, if you ask a leader or leadership as something that someone that should not command for a respect, but he must be a demand for respect, but he should be command for the respect. That means people even can worship on your way or the leading skills. So what I meant here is, when you want to become a leader, you should acquire at least the way how to really organize the intellects that you own by yourself, which differs from others. Well, have a look at this model, the full range leadership styles model, which I have used this in research. Why I have picked up this research model? Because this is one of the away from the traditional type of leadership theory and model, which have transformational, transactional and passive avoidance. If you ask me, transformationals, which is consisting of five main things: build trust, acts with integrities and inspire others, encourage innovative thinking and coaches the peoples or the subordinates within you. It's very showing a high profile of leader. And at the same time, this model is also consisting of MBA by A and MBP. That means it's management by expectations, by avoiding some mistakes, or sometimes when it happened to be the mistakes, they will immediately bring up some rules and regulations. So this is also included in this model. So that is why I have picked. At the same time, we also have a passive avoidant type of leadership style in this model. So to serve the purpose of the study, I have used the full range leadership model, which was introduced by Bass. And it is one of the perfect model, I would say, that consisting of all kind of positive to the negative type of leading skills. Well, move on to the independent variables in this research is organizational commitment. And my dear fellow participants, I'm not going to read this to you, but very precisely, I would like to explain what is organizational commitment, which means that how much we are psychologically attached to the workplace or work environment or with the peoples that we are working in. So in this research, precisely, I'm looking at three types of commitment that are affective, continuance, and normative commitments. It means how do we work at the workplace, how we are receiving the leading pressure, so-called, or a kind of authorization towards us, and at the same time, we are willing to manage or balance that towards showing our psychological attachments to our workplace. And at the same time, how does this relationship is being moderated by the culture that innate within us, that the way that we have been brought up in this pluralistic society. Well, national culture, that's what I have used in this study, has the moderator, which was systematically was introduced by Claghorn and Strasbourg, and I have used nine types of national culture in this studies, which was introduced in a Globe research, which was done in 2001. It is a very huge research done in overall country, which is include Southern Asian countries, and they have proven in the study that Malaysia and also other Asian countries were having a very high power distance, which is one of the national culture dimensions. So I would like to see whether it is true in the field of education. Because this research is being done was done in the educational field. And if you ask me why, very straight and simple answer for this, because I'm a teacher, so I would like to see something that is near to me and how does it work. So when I came through all these studies that has been done by Globe, and I was interested to know how this dimension of national cultures influence or moderating or giving some intervening effects to the ready relationships between leadership style and also the organizational commitment among the subordinates. Well, the nine national culture I've used in the study were uncertainty avoidance, power distance, which are very straightforward to understand. Harmony means how do we work with the peoples around us, our co-workers, and also the upper level management people. Performance orientation. Collectivism, which really we can avoid that because we living in a pluralistic society, we have to work in a group. That's something that is not avoidable. Even in the Globe study, it was proven that Southern Asian countries like Thailand, Singapore, Vietnam, Indonesia, all these countries are having a high collectivism, the way the people are working. And number six, I've used polychronic and monochronic. I've added here this. Polychronic and monochronic means is a ways approach how work is being done. It is more to can we say that, for example, like certain peoples, they are very introvert when doing work. I can't have sounds, background noise, anything when I'm doing work. I have to concentrate. But certain peoples, they don't care. They are very extrovert. They like noises. So the teachers who are in sitting in their teachers' rooms, they don't care about what's happening behind, but they focus. So they're multitasking of people. So that type of culture is also being was researched here. The impact of that dimensions between leadership styles and organization commitment. Next was the masculinity and femininity, and lastly is religions, which is a really unavoidable things within us, because we in Malaysians, specifically where the research was done, we are having our own beliefs, our culture, each and everything we have, the way how we bring up. I can't do a research, for instance, like I would say I have given one work to a Malay, to a Chinese or to Indian, the same job, and how it was being done, and what is the impact with the races, how do they do work? It's more kind of sensitivity. But when it comes to a national culture, one culture that the community is bringing up together, it sounds more interesting, and it's a plus point in this research. All right, why I've chosen this national culture? Because I would say that have said that just now, we have in the research has been proven in Malaysia we're having a high power distance, and we are also a collectivism based on work, and we also Malaysia is seems a pluralistic society. We have to consider this national culture. You know, you see, in Malaysia we having a face value. We simply don't humiliate peoples, even though there are some mistakes or anything had happened in the organization. We normally save the people's face. So, and how does all this really impact the work? You know, when it comes to a strict, so-called a traditional way of leading, not based on the charismatics, you know, not to be also transformation type of leaderships. When I'm say I'm strict, you have to follow that kind of leaderships. There are so many cultural, so-called traditional types of leadership. How does this national culture affecting that relationship? So that is why I have chosen this national culture in the study as a moderator. Well, let's move on to the purpose. So very simple, in a simpler way, the purpose of the study is to see the relationship between leadership styles and organizational commitment among the national culture, with impact of national culture dimensions in national primary schools in state of Johor. All right, and this study have four objective mainly, which I will explain in detail when I'm discussing about the results and results slide. Well, coming back, coming to the research sample, these studies has occupied simple random sampling, stratified random simple random sampling, and it was taken 607 of teachers from three types of school that having grade A's, entitled with grade A means they're having more than thousands of peoples in the schools, and so it's a huge number of people. So from there, I want to see how the teachers are really having the impacts of leading, and also how do they show their commitment to the work, and at the same time how their culture is influencing or having some interfering in that relationship. All right. Data collections. Okay, the data here I've collected using a quantitative, using a questionnaire survey, and the data were took about 6 months for me to distribute. And personally, I went and meet the teachers, having some meetings with them, the headmasters, you know, perform pursuing some letters from the PPD officers, and so many process goes on. So when I'm collecting the survey questions, it was what you call very good experience for me actually. So the why I have chosen what you call the quantitative base, because it will be the one, it was the only way that I can be used to formulate a hypothesis based on the objective I have built, and from that I can what you call I can explain how this hypothesis is true or not true, and how significant is the my research study. Well, analysis part. In this data research, the data was analyzed using a partial least square path modeling, PLSMPM, which was a very a newest latest way of analyzing data, because I'm using moderator. So when I've used moderator with this path modeling, it was very fantastic to see the numbers, the t values, and how the validations and reliabilities of the questionnaires and the studies was it was perfect to use this method to analyze the objective of this research. Yeah, well, in this result and discussion, okay, the objective one was to examine the relationship between full range leadership styles and organizational commitment, and the result shows that transformational and transactional, which means they have three types of leadership in the full range leadership styles. Transformational and transactionals have influenced the dependent variable, which is organizational commitment, and transformational and transactional behavior shows positive effects on the teacher's commitment. Well, on the second objective, which was to identify the most influential dimensions from Each full-range leadership, that means transformation, transactional, and also the laissez faire towards the organizational commitment, shows individually each dimensions have a relationship with organizational teachers' commitment, and they are varies. So it is being indicated that headmasters have adopted organizational, transformational leadership behavior to correlate with teachers' commitment at the workplace. Well, for the objective 3 and 4, it was to examine the moderating effect of national culture dimension and also to see which is the most significant dimensions from that 9 national culture dimension have used. And the third objective have reflected that yes, national culture was moderating the effect of full range leadership and organizational commitment. So it makes sense that I have used this in my research, and it was truth enough to defend that it is really a plus point to do this national culture dimensions in a research, because it's something within us, so it has to be in practice to use how it's actually impact the other dependent, so-called dependent or independent variables in any studies, for example, like motivations or climates or anything. And specifically from 9 types of national culture, the most contributing was the in-group collectivism. So it is a really perfect, and it was same as what the results found in 2001 about Malaysians, that we are having a high collectivism. Well, finally, to the conclusions, and again, once again, I'm not going to read this to you, but very precisely, I would like to say that it was a real research that have raised up and zeal the motivation among us, that showing the national culture dimension among us in Malaysians is really reflecting an impact to the work environment. Seriously, because everyone, when we give some works, you know, they have their own way of doing it. But when it comes to leader, he had to tolerate all this. So actually, in terms of saying tolerate, it has to be in that way, because everybody was brought up in their own styles at according to their own norm, their beliefs, you know, the traditions and everything. So when all this mingle up, and when it comes to working at one place, we are carrying the one national culture all together. So in such a way, how does these really impacting the way of working at the workplace, was something wonderful to research about, and that was found out in this research, and it was proven the previous studies are showing that Malaysians having high in-group collectivism and a high power distance is really true, because besides in-group collectivism, in this study, power distance also having showed that having a high range of the T value. Well, from the studies, it was found out that basically teachers, especially in this situations, in pandemic situation now, we are moving toward a lot of changes, you know. So its knowledge base is being more on the internets and everything. So we are moving towards excellence and glory, and towards more distinction places. So in being an important person in molding the students from from these schools or any other education sites, so it is something very important. We conduct research among the teachers and also the headmasters or whoever in the education field to find out what it's really helping them to enhance their potentials, to bring up our vision together and achieve that for the sake of the every peoples in this Malaysian pluralistic society. And this research, I believe that it helped us to understand by researching only 2 variables, like a relationship between motivations and work performance and so-called commitment with leadership styles. We also have to think what are the intermediate or the third variables that could really impact it, and depending on the community that we are doing the research. So this is one of the key points that have been reflected in this research. And that's all from me today, and I hope that you have a very short and precise understanding about this research. And if you require any clarifications, further clarifications, or do have any questions about the research, you may post it, and I would be it would be my pleasure to answer you at the soonest time. And thank you very much to everyone who have enjoyed those presentations, I hope. Thank you, and see you all again in the future. Bye-bye.